Let's get straight to the point. There are two types of webhooks in n8n. Test webhooks are used to recognize data structure, and production webhooks are used to activate the workflow. Right now I'm going to change the path of my webhook, copy the address and paste it in the new card of my browser. So right now I've got the message that workflow was started, and there we go. We received the data from our webhook call. Now it's time to pass some parameters to this workflow. I'm going to add two parameters. The first one is brand, which has the value workflows, and the second one is parameter action, which has the value subscribe. I'm going to click listen for the event and activate the address. Now the parameters should be passed to the webhook node in my n8n workflow. Now let's make a use of those parameters and build something around them. So I'm going to pin the data and add the next steps of the workflow. Depending on the values of webhook parameters, I want to redirect the user to the very specific websites. So I'm going to use ifNode from n8n library to check if action parameter from my URL is equal to value subscribe or not. For this purpose, I'm adding new string condition in my if node, and as a value 1 I point to the action parameter from webhook, and as a value 2 I simply type in subscribe. Now it's also necessary to change the respond mode from immediately to using respond to webhook node, because we are going to add one to our canvas. So let's search now for the respond to webhook node in n8n and connect it with true branch of if node. I'm going also to add some options here. The first one is change the value of respond with to no data, and as a respond code I'm going to point to 308. Now we just need to point to the URL of our website. So add the response header, and as a name type in location, and as a value type in the URL of your website. Because I like to keep my workflow organized, I just want to rename the node to redirect to workflows. I'm going right now to close this window and add the last one node, which is no operation node. So basically, when the value of action parameter is equal to subscribe, the workflow is going to redirect the user to my website. But in any other case, for example, when the value of this parameter is unsubscribe, nothing will happen. So now I want to test my workflow. So I will copy the production URL, but to make it work, I need to activate the workflow. Now I just need to open new browser tab, paste my webhook URL and add the parameter action. And let's set the value to subscribe. Now I should be redirected to my homepage. And yes, this is what happens. But when I modify the URL and change the parameter, for example, to value unsubscribe, nothing will happen. Actually, we are just gonna receive the message that workflow executed successfully. Now I'm going to modify this workflow to return the actual HTML page. So as you can see, there are already two HTML nodes in my workflow. I've also prepared simple HTML notification page and added the brand parameter to display it to the user if he subscribed or unsubscribed, for example, to the newsletter. So this workflow, according to the values of parameters, should generate and return to the user actual HTML pages. Now I want to test my workflow again, but make a little difference. I will add also the parameter brand and type in workflows. And as an action, I want to type subscribe. And just after a few seconds, we should see a notification page fully generated according to the parameters. When I change right now the value of brand parameter, HTML page should be generated once again. Similar thing should happen when I change the value of action parameter to unsubscribe. We should see in a second the red window with text unsubscribed. Webhooks are used also to trigger other workflows. So I'm going to add the first workflow called action and add the webhook, which has the path trigger. Now I want to copy the production webhook and activate this workflow. The next step is to create another workflow, which is the trigger for the action workflow. So I'm going to create it and rename it to trigger. In this example, I'm going to take the schedule node and set the value to 15 seconds. Basically, in order to execute the other workflow, we can use execute workflow node from n8n, which is a really cool option. But today we want to use webhooks for this purpose, so I'm going to search for HTTP request node and paste the address of the webhook from the second workflow. Right now we just need to save the workflow, activate it, and go to the executions tab. Right now we should see that trigger workflow executes the action workflow, and it happens in some kind of loop every 15 seconds. And that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and to my newsletter, link in the description, and see you in the next video. Bye.